In an article posted today by Paul Joseph Watson, the headline reads, Sarah Palin says feds are stockpiling bullets for civil unrest. She sounds like a conspiracy theorist. You've got even neocons fessing up to what InfoWars has made the public aware of. And former governor of Alaska, Sarah Palin, has warned that the federal government is stockpiling bullets in preparation for civil unrest, adding that America is finished if it cannot deal with its debt problems. She wrote that on her Facebook page. And, you know, now you have neocons from Mark Levin, Michael Savage, now Sarah Palin, admitting that the federal government is arming itself to the teeth. And the only people who don't know about that now or who act like they don't know this is going on is the federal government. Whenever you've got warmongering neocons acknowledging that the government is stockpiling, you know the government is stockpiling. And what's amazing here is that InfoWars is breaking this story. You're always hearing that InfoWars is irrelevant, the alternative media is irrelevant, yet we're responsible for the discussion that is taking place in politics today. Paul Joseph Watson broke this story along with Alex Jones. And again, now you've got neocon Sarah Palin talking about this. For more on this issue, we go to our very own David Knight. So, David Knight, tell us a little bit about your thoughts on this issue.
Well, the media has gone into full damage control with this after Sarah Palin came out with it. You've got Politico, you've got Atlantic Wire, you've got Huffington Post. You've got everybody basically saying these are debunked conspiracy theories. And they're not debunked. We're not making this up. As a matter of fact, it was Politico that even linked Sarah Palin to Alex Jones, you know, and says she joins Alex Jones and InfoWars and looking at this. I've got a graph here that basically shows how in the last 10 months the DHS has ramped this up. And Watson pulled these figures from FedBiz and from a couple of different sites here that are FedBid and Federal Business Opportunities. This one right here is actually a publication of the GSA. This is the main source for contractors to get information about what the federal government is buying. So this is public information. This is coming from the Fed's site. So there's no dispute that they're putting out bids to get these things. The question is, why are they buying so much ammunition? Well, the media has tried to explain that away with a couple of attempts. First, they came back and they said, well, last summer they started talking about the smallest purchases. They talked about 174,000 from Social Security Administration. They talked about 46,000 from the Weather Service, from NOAA. And they tried to explain it away and say, this is just for practice. This is for target practice. But we're not talking about a few hundred thousand. We're talking about hundreds of millions of purchases. And when the very first one of these came out at 200 million, people were saying, why are they buying so much ammunition? But they quickly doubled down on that and bought 450 more million just a couple of months after that. And then a couple of months after that, they got another 750 million. Then another month after that, they got another 200 million. I mean, they're just ramping up on this.
Tell us about war. Like, if these bullets were all, first of all, talk about hollow points very quickly.
Right, right.
And talk about war. How, let's just say this was all used for war. How
Good
long
point.
Would that be for?
Good point. You know, when they're talking about it being for target practice and they're talking about saving money, hollow points are very expensive. You don't use those for target practice. So it's ludicrous from that standpoint. If you know anything about firearms, you know that they're not going to buy hollow points for firearms practice. But if you look back at the amount of ammunition that was being used at the peak of the Iraq War, that was 5.5 million rounds a month, okay? So you're still looking at the quantities that they bought. That would be about 24 to 30 years worth of ammunition if they're fighting a war the size of the Iraq War. I think they want to basically starve the marketplace of ammunition. Because if you've got guns and no ammunition, it's like having a car with no gas. Okay, it's pretty. And one thing that they can do is they can essentially suck all the oxygen out of the marketplace, suck all the ammunition out of the marketplace with these gigantic purchases. But we found out just a couple of months ago, people going through and looking at the recycling documents coming out of Fort Drum in New York found that they are not selling their once-used brass, but they're turning it, they're spending extra money to turn it into brass scrap and selling it to the Chinese as scrap metal instead of selling it back into the United States market as once-used brass, which would help to keep the price of ammunition down.
All right, David, thank you so much for that analysis.
Thank you, David.
Now, in other news, Rasmussen released a poll today that showed that 40% say internet is the best way to get news, 37% say TV. Now, some of that is obviously going to be for convenience, why people like getting their news from the internet, because they don't have to wait for commercials or for 6 or 7 o'clock. But a lot of that is also the credibility of alternative news sites such as InfoWars. Again, we talked about Sarah Palin. She's made aware of the stockpiling. Because of InfoWars breaking that story. Now, in other news, in an article posted today on InfoWars.com by Paul Joseph Watson, the headline reads, Tech Guru Warns of Internet Disaster. Scientist Danny Hillis calls for Internet Plan B in times of emergency. Inventor and scientist Danny Hillis warns that the Internet has expanded it way beyond its limits and is set for a disaster, calling for an Internet Plan B that would operate in times of emergency. And he basically cited the Stuxnet virus that happened earlier this year. We all know that virus was a false flag attack, and the reason why scientists and members of the government are saying that we need a plan B and we need to regulate the internet is because they obviously want to regulate the internet. They want to control who gets to use the internet. And later on in the article, it says internet ID cards could be issued or licenses would be issued to individuals who have proven themselves to be well-behaved citizens. Those have not used the web for illegal downloads, hacking, or God forbid, criticizing officialdom. That's where we're headed, where you're going to need an internet license to use the internet. And this is all part of a false flag attack so that the government could ultimately regulate the internet. Now, in our last news story, according to the Los Angeles Times, Secretary of State John Kerry pledges $60 million in aid to Syrian opposition forces. And the article says Secretary of State John Kerry pledged an additional $60 million in aid to Syrian opposition forces, including food and medical support directly to armed rebels for the first time, but turning aside their demand for weapons. And later on, the article says, this is a quote from the secretary, "We express our commitment to helping the Syrian people in order to achieve their goal to live in a free and a safe and a just society. Their goal is our goal." So there you go. This has blowback written all over it. We shouldn't be involved in this situation. In my estimation, people in the Middle East don't appreciate our meddling in their affairs. Again, this looks like blowback, and many of those individuals are Al-Qaeda members. I thought we were at war with those individuals. Many of the individuals who they're helping. Now, we're going to go to our daily quote, and it comes from Mr. Muhammad Gandhi, and it reads, "Providence has its appointed hour for everything. We cannot command results. We can only strive." Mahatma Gandhi. And in just a minute, we will be back with Reverend Childress from blackgenocide.org. We're going to talk about the 40th anniversary of that diabolical ruling, Roe versus Wade.
ProPure is introducing Pro-1. All of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. This is the Pro-1 by ProPure. You wanted it, you got it. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It cuts out the acid derivative of fluoride. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gates, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia, and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. This is a revolution against the tyrants. They love putting the toxic acid base of fluoride into your water. They love the fact that it's an adjuvant supercharging the trace Prozac in the water and the hormones and the other chemicals. By cutting out fluoride, you cut out the turbocharger in all the poison being artificially introduced into your body. This is what I use. It's a win-win. You get a high-quality product at the lowest price. You support the InfoWar. Get your ProPure with the new Pro One filter today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.